Hey, this is Neha and you're watching my channel English with Neha Juneja. Today I'll be explaining the poem A Tiger in the Zoo, which is in the CBSE Class 10th First Flight book. A Tiger in the Zoo is written by Leslie Norris. George Leslie Norris was a prize-winning, renowned Welsh poet and a short story writer. The poem has two distinct settings. First setting is of zoo, where the tiger is kept in the cage and the poet tries to explain the agony and helplessness of a caged tiger that lives in a zoo. Second setting is of the natural wild habitat of the tiger where it actually belongs. The poem comprises of 5 stanzas. Each stanza consists of 4 lines and the rhyme scheme followed in all the stanzas is ABCB. First stanza, he stalks in his vivid stripes the few steps of his cage on pads of velvet quiet in his quiet rage. Stalk stands for follows. Vivid means bright colored. Pad means paws of tiger. Rage stands for anger. In this stanza, the poet describes the appearance of the tiger in the zoo and its daily movements. The tiger that is confined in the zoo moves around in the cage under his bright colored skin. The tiger can take only a few steps because he has very soft feet like velvet, because of which there is no sound of the tiger's footsteps. The tiger tries to control his anger by quietly walking in the limited area of this cage. Literary devices used in the first stanza. Personification. The tiger is personified instead of using it. The poet has used he for the tiger. He has used he or his for the tiger. Metaphor. Tiger's paws are compared with velvet, pads of velvet. Next is enjambment. One line, thought or idea continues to the next line without any punctuation mark is known as enjambment. Here in the first 2 lines, enjambment is there. For example, he stalks in his vivid stripes the few steps of his cage. Then imagery. Here the poet has tried to create an image of a tiger that we can clearly visualize. Consonants. Repetition of consonant sounds in the closely connected words is known as consonants. For example, he stalks in his vivid stripes. The sound of S is evident in stalks, his, and stripes. Next is assonance, use of vowel sound I. In the line, he stalks in his vivid stripes. Oxymoron, use of adjectives opposite in meaning. In the last line, we can see in his quiet rage. Quiet and rage both are adjectives but used for opposite meanings. Second stanza, he should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass near the waterhole where plump deer pass. Lurking stands for hiding. Sliding means moving. Plump means chubby. If the tiger was free, he would have hid himself behind the long grass near the waterhole or pool and could easily catch a deer in order to have it as its food. Here the poet conveys that the natural habitat of a tiger is to live in jungle, where he could catch its prey easily, but a tiger in a cage cannot do so. Literary devices used in second stanza, enjambment, we have already read it. In the lines, sliding through long grass near the water hole where plump deer pass. Alliteration, use of sound P at the start of 2 words plump and pass in the following line where plump deer pass. Imagery, the poet has tried to create an image of tiger's activities in the line lurking in shadow. Stanza 3, he should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge, baring his white fangs, his claws terrorizing the village. Snarling stands for warning sounds made by animals. Baring means showing, white fangs, white teeth of animals. Here the poet says that if the tiger would have been free, he would have snarled around the houses located at the outskirts of the forest. He would terrorize people with his sharp tooth and claws. It would create fear among the people. Now, literary devices used in stanza 3, enjambment, where line continues to next line without punctuation marks. For example, he should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge. Onomatopoeia, using words which denote sound, the word snarling. Assonance, use a vowel sound O and I in these lines. He should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge, baring his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. Here, in the word should, around and houses, there is sound of O, and baring his white and his I sound is there. Consonants is there. Use of consonant sound S. End the line, baring his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. His fangs and his claws. Stanza 4. But he is locked in a concrete cell, his strength behind bars, stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. Concrete means building made of bricks, cement, sand and water. Stalking means striding. Now, the poet comes to the reality of the tiger that is inside the cage. He says that the tiger is confined in a strong cell, which is made of strong building material. He further says that, as the tiger is behind bars, so his ferociousness is also behind the bars. He just stalks in the cage. He never tries to terrorize the visitors because his power is restricted by the cage. Therefore, he never tries to terrorize the visitors as he cannot attack them. Literary devices used in stanza 4. Personification. The tiger is personified because the poet refers him as he. Assonance. Use a vowel sound E in the line. But he is locked in a concrete cell. Consonants. Use of consonant sound S in the words his strength bars. Alliteration. Use of sound B at the start of two words behind bars. Stanza 5. He hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars, and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. Patrolling means to guard. The poet says that in the night, the tiger hears the sounds of the patrolling cars. Patrolling cars are the vehicles of police which are used to guard at night. So in the night, the tiger hears the sounds of these cars. He then stares at the shining stars with his shining eyes. The poet wants to say that the tiger is sad, and as he is confined in the cage, so he cannot do anything. Therefore, he stares at the stars in the night and tries to divert his thoughts towards them. Literary devices used in stanza 5. Enjambment. Line 3 continues to line 4 without any punctuation mark and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. Alliteration. Use of sound H in the starting of two words he hears. Assonance. Use of I sound in the words with, his and brilliant. Do like, share and subscribe my channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon. Goodbye.